Very good morning to everyone. In this training program, now we will discuss about field botany and importance of field botany, how field botany discover new opportunity for biological sciences. Field botany is a base of ecology, taxonomy, ethnobotany, conservation, biochemistry, pharmacology and clinical microbiology. So I think we have already discussed about it, that every health problem related to biological has in it the seed of its solution. So already discussed. So how we will start the field work? First field work, ethnobotanical information, collection of plant parts, collection of plant specimen, herbarium preparation and deposition, voucher number, powder of collected parts, extraction, crude extract of different solvent, and then experimental work. So field botany minimize the gap between field and lab. So ethics like, do you have permission to collect the plant specimen from the selected area? You should never collect plant specimen from a national park, wildlife sanctuary, biosphere reserve and MPCA. Without permission from the authorities for some areas, you may also need a collecting permit from local people. Are there enough plants to justify your works? Do you have a good reason for killing or damaging the plant? Field data book. Collection of information on diet observation, information from local community, geographical observation, morphology, vegetation, and associationship. So these all things we include in field data book. So this is a field data book, 7 component. I designed it. Collector, species, location, morphology, habitat, specimen, and additional note. This is our field data book. These are some important points for field data book, like collection date, collector name, collector number, country, locality, elevation, description, habitat, associated species, identification note, family, scientific name, authority, common name. Photography for collection, at least habitat photo need 5 to 10. Whole plant, plant parts, associated plant, flower parts, fruit, seeds, root. Tools for collection like clippers, diggers, cloth bag, plastic or paper bags, field notebook, pencil, graph paper, tag, press, cutter and knife, GPS, scale, tissue paper, newspaper, blotting paper, slide, clippers. This is a plant tag, family, genus, species, collection date, location, GPS. These things we can include. Careful during collection. For woody plant, be sure it has a fruit and that you collect more than a single leaf. Don't forget to record the height of the tree or shrub in meter. For herbaceous plant, collect plants with flower. Do not separate parts unless absolutely necessary. For a small herbaceous plant, collect the root and either whole stem or top and bottom. Attach a tag to your plant as you collect them. Give conjugative number to each plant you collect and use the same number in your field notebook and on your tag. Press your plants while they are fresh. Pressing so both sides of leaves typically includes more than a single specimen, especially multiple flowers and or fruit. Topography, we should keep ideas about the topography. We should have idea about the topography like coastline, plain, undulating land, hills, mountain, plateau, depression, rises, slope, artificial slopes, flat, waterways, water bodies, host organism for parasite or epiphyte, growth form like trees, shrub, subshrub, herb, fern, parasite, liana, grass. So we have to idea about the growth form. Abundance, we should know about the abundance before the collection, like this is the random, clumped, strongly clumped, regular. So from the regular we can collect type specimen like holotype, lectotype, neotype, cenotype, paratype, isotype. We should know about the type specimen. For the holotype, the person first proposing the name stated which specimen was to be regarded as the type specimen. Leptotype, the person who first proposed the name did not designate a type specimen. Neotype, sometimes holotype and leptotypes are lost or destroyed. The most notorious instance when this way when this was the destruction of all types in the Berlin herbarium by Allied bombing during World War II. Cellotype, paratype, isotype, they are similarly duplicate of a type specimen. This is the isotype. This is the one herbarium sheet, my collection. So a herbarium is better than any restoration for conservation. Every biologist should make one in research life. Primary step for conservation of bio wealth. So herbarium catalog of a specimen with traditional therapeutic information. Herbarium sheet, comparison of usage with folk name from herbarium sheet, analysis of plant taxa and study of distributional behavior. Historical herbaria are relevant source of traditional practices for development of pharmacology. Herbarium techniques. You can observe collecting plant material for herbarium, initial pressing in the field, some collected material showing labeling. Labeling is important. Collector on expeditions writing notes about their plant. This is also important, like locality, habitat, GPS, field identification key, collector's name, date of collection, plant description. You can observe when collecting plants in the field, you need to press and dry them straight away to keep them in good condition. You can observe very good condition. You can observe my collection. Checking the specimen before mounting them to a herbarium sheet. You can observe the label, which is the correct label. You can observe here. Okay, both sides of the leaves should be shown so we can observe their morphological character. You can observe here the best type of labeling. This is the information sheet about the herbarium. You can observe here two herbarium, Darwin original herbarium specimen at present day herbarium collection. These are my herbarium. Okay, now we will discuss about the phytochemistry of a plant species or medicinal plant. So fruits are used traditionally to improve immunity among the whole community, and tubers are used traditionally against skin infection by Bathory tribes. It is a fruit of Smilax jalanica. How we can believe that both usages are correct? So we have to do some experimental works for validation. So fruit-food relationship between human and plant, that is called ethnobotany. I think in last sessions we have discussed it about the importance. So ethnobotany, it means interaction between human and plant, traditional practices using plant as a medicine, indigenous food habit, plant classification as per usage, cultivation of traditional plants, local plants used for shelter, household works, and to get money, that is non-timber forest producer. So this is ethnobotany. I think we discussed about the Richard Evans, about the ethnobotany, there the different types of ethnobotany, their component, their parts, the father of Indian ethnobotany, S.K. Jain. So now about the tribes. So we should know about the tribes, because tribes is an important part of ethnobotany. Tribal population in world, 370 million people, 70 countries worldwide. India has the world largest tribal population, the Gond, and the Brazil is the Guarani. So Guarani here is the Adivasi. Constitution of India has recognized tribal communities in India under Schedule 5 of the Constitution, hence the tribe recognized by the Constitution are known as Scheduled Tribe. So indigenous people descend from population who inhabited inside a identified boundaries like Domariya Kando. Tribal people, their social, culture, economic condition distinguish them from other sections of the national community like Santhal. So Adivasi, we have discussed about the Adivasi. Okay, population of tribals in India, you can observe maximum in Madhya Pradesh, Odisha, Maharashtra, Rajasthan, Chhattisgarh. So maximum population, that means maximum usage of plant, that means maximum ethnobotany. In Northeast, they are unexplored particularly. So we have a lot of opportunity there. So this is the major tribal group, Gond, Bhil, Santhal, Great Andamanese, Khasi, Garo, Angami, Munda. India has approximately 645 groups. And among in 645, 75 belongs to PGT, primitive tribal group. So primitive tribal group 75, Odisha 13, Andhra Pradesh 12, Jharkhand 9, Madhya Pradesh, मध्य प्रदेश एंड छत्तीसगढ़ 7, तमिलनाडु 6, केरला अंडमान गुजरात 5, नॉर्थ ईस्ट त्रिपुरा एंड मणिपुर 2. सो बोंडो ट्राइब ऑफ ओडिशा, डोंगरिया कंदो ए ट्राइब फ्रॉम ओडिशा, आई वाज वर्किंग विद देम. वुमेन ऑफ डोंगरिया कंदो ए ट्राइब फ्रॉम ओडिशा, सो वी डिड सम वर्क विद ट्राइबल. दिस इज, दीज आर द रिजल्ट्स यू कैन ऑब्जर्व. दिस इज द wine preparation inside the forest, a technique you can observe, the technique, a beautiful technique. So ethnobotany means community health problem landscape. We have discussed in the last sessions about these all mathematical terms, code of ethics, national biodiversity authority, tribal claims. These are the informants you can observe here, how I have arranged. It should be more than 35 years old. Ethnobotany, it means ecology, okay, pharmacology, genetics, microbiology, statics, indigenous law, economics, literature, anthropology, geography. So these all are interrelated to the ethnobotany or linked with ethnobotany. So these, I think, the mathematical terms we have already discussed in the last session. So you can observe the last session, okay, PPT or video. So here you can observe the bioactive compound. This is the most important part of medicinal plant, because due to the availability of bioactive compounds, they are medicinal plant or they have curative values. So the common terminology of phytochemistry, like medicinal plant, bioactive compounds, crude extract, primary metabolites, secondary metabolites, so these are the common terminology. Solvent for phytochemistry, like water, alcohol, chloroform, ether, ionic liquid, acetone, polar or non-polar group. So this is the polarity index you can observe. N-hexane, lowest, maximum water. So N-hexane, petroleum ether, diethyl ether, ethyl acetine, chloroform, dichloromethane, acetone, N-butanol, ethanol, methanol, and water. Extraction method, like decoction, maceration, percolation, chocolate extraction, infusion, ultrasound assisted extraction, microwave assisted extraction, and digestion. So you can observe the factors to be considered as extraction method, like solubility to heat, best chocolate method, nature of solvent, volatile, succinate, polar or water, maceration, duration of extraction, if long, maceration is best for long exposure, volume of crude extract for succinate method, if less volume. So these are the important phytochemicals like alkaloid, glycoside, esteroid, triterpenoids, tannin, flavonoid, phenol, saponin, flavotenins, carbonyl, reducing sugar, amino acid, cardiac glycoside, diterpenes, protein, carbohydrate, lipid, quinins, enzyme, and bioactive compounds like plant bioactive compounds, animal bioactive compounds, bacterial bioactive compounds, fungal bioactive compounds. The major bioactive compounds are alkaloids, phenolic, glycosides, and triterpenoids. Okay, role of secondary metabolites. Some of them attract animals for pollination and seed dispersal. They are used by the plants in their defense against herbivores and pathogens. They act as agents of plant-plant competition. They are used in making drugs, insecticide, flavor, pigments, scents, rubber, spices, and other industrial material like gum and resin. These are the, like you can observe the phytochemicals, primary and secondary, responsible for the medicinal values, origin behind their synthesis we will discuss. So this is the origins, okay, like stress, abiotic and biotic stress. Fungal secondary metabolites are a major source of medicinally important compounds such as penicillin, the anti-cholesterol compound like lovastatins. So stress is important. You can observe the stress, how the compounds are synthesizing, they are chemical weapons, so exogenous stress, and you can observe the biotic compounds as the cell's defense mechanism. So service of secondary metabolites, these are the service luggage, competitive weapons used against other bacteria, fungi, amoeba, plants, insects, and large animals, as metal transporting agent, okay, as agent of symbiosis between microbes and plants, nematodes, insects, and higher animals, as sexual hormones, as differentiation effectors. Secondary metabolites also can slow down germination of spores until a less competitive environment and more favorable condition for growth exist. Protect the dormant or initiated spore from consumption by amoeba, or cleanse the immediate environment of competing microorganism during germination. You can observe here, sir, I designed this due to a stress, okay, saponin. So staining now, the herbivores will not consume the Dioscorea species. These all are stress, how synthesized. These are the most important plant secondary metabolites, can be classified into four major classes: terpenoids, phenolic compound, alkaloids, and sulfur containing compounds. You can observe anthocyanin, okay, fruit, vegetable, nuts, then flavones, flavanols, isoflavonoids. So these are the parts of plants, and if they are available, the plants become medicinal plants. As per the family, like if we have to search asteroid, we have to think about the Apocynaceae, Asclepiadaceae, Solanaceae, Buxaceae, Liliaceae. If we have to work, okay, now the industrial uses like wastewater treatment, leather industry, dyeing industries, food additives, veterinary applications. Here you can observe for the phenolic compounds, these are the properties. For steroids, these are the properties. Okay. For saponin, like antifungal and then insecticidal, okay, the anti-cancer, these are the properties. And you can observe the tannin, terpenes, these are the properties. Important facts about the selected bioactive compounds. Bioactive compounds extracted from Clostridium is responsible for muscle paralysis, but also useful in migraine and cosmetic purposes. The bioactive compounds present in oyster mushroom is able to reduce the cholesterol level. Like artemisinin is used as an anti-malarial agent. Bioactive compounds available in coniferous trees are used against pancreatic cancer, ovarian cancer, lung cancer, etc. Bioactive compounds present in atropa is used against sleeping disorders. Bioactive compounds present in digitalis species used to treat the heart problems. So these are the important facts about the medicinal plants, their secondary metabolites, ethnobotany, and how they are closely interrelated to each other. So thank you very much for this session.